These are the incisors, and these are the canines. The surface of the tooth that is facing towards the lips is known as the labial surface. So these surfaces are known as the labial surface. These are the premolars and these are the molars. So the surface that is this surface is adjacent to the cheek or the buccal mucosa. That's why this surface is known as the buccal surface. So collectively these surfaces, the labial surface, that from canine to canine, the labial surface and the buccal from premolar, first premolar till the posterior third molar. So these surfaces are collectively known as the labial, and the buccal surfaces are collectively known as the facial surfaces. So these surfaces are collectively known as the facial surfaces. These are the upper anterior teeth from canine to canine. And these are the lower anterior teeth from canine to canine. So the cutting surface of an anterior teeth, these are the cutting surfaces. These all are the cutting surface of an anterior teeth. So these surfaces are known as the incisal surface in the lower arch. These surfaces are known as the incisal surfaces. These are the premolars and these are the molars. These are the posterior teeth. So the biting surface of posterior teeth, these are the biting surface. So these biting surfaces of the posterior teeth are known as the occlusal surfaces. Similarly, in the lower arch, these are the biting surface of the posterior teeth. So these biting surfaces are known as the occlusal surfaces. So maxillary arch, the surface of the tooth that is just adjacent to the palate, is known as the palatal surface. So these are the palatal surfaces. These are the palatal surfaces. In the mandibular arch, this surface is just adjacent to the tongue. So this surface is just adjacent to the tongue. So these surfaces are known as the lingual surfaces. So these surfaces are known as the lingual surfaces. So this is a midline that divides the maxillary quadrant into two equal halves. Similar is in the mandibular arch. So this is a midline that divides the mandibular quadrant into two equal halves. So this is a midline. So the surface of the tooth that is near to the midline is the mesial surface. So this surface is of the central incisor that is near to the midline is the mesial surface, and this surface that is in contact with the lateral incisor that is away from the midline. So this surface of the central incisor is the distal surface. So collectively the mesial surface and the distal surface, collectively they are known as the proximal surfaces.